just going to take you a ride in our Mercedes-Benz C-Class 2.1. It's the C220 CDI BLUEEFFICIENCY AMG Sport Plus, and it's a 7G Tronic. Really, really nice car. Everything about the car, very, very stylish. It's coupe. With the AMG kit, you have the brushed aluminium here. You've got red stitching, you've got red seat belts. It's got a rear spoiler, very discreet little spoiler. The sports steering wheel with the squared off bottom. Paddle shift, cruise control. It has the just shift all my wires to the microphone and the camera. It has sat nav, Bluetooth. The sat nav you can control from this thumb wheel here on the just forward of the front central armrest. Again, just click that on, put the map on, and zoom in so you can see what's coming. Zoom out as I've just done. I've been using this car for the last couple of days and it's absolutely ideal for me. Very, very economical. It's got a height and reach adjustable steering wheel. Steering very, very precise. Good sporty feel about it, very comfortable driving position. Front central armrest again, and the armrest on the door, just the right height for me. The one thing that does kind of freak me out when I get in, which shouldn't do, is when you turn the ignition on, it has a seatbelt pretensioner. So you've pulled your seatbelt on, you switch the ignition on, and all of a sudden your seatbelt starts going tighter as if somebody's going to strangle you from the back seat. Perhaps I'm just a little bit paranoid. The car, as I say, is fantastic. And I look forward to driving it, to be fair. Gas on this dual carriageway, and as you can see, diesel engine takes off great. You know, bumps or knocks or groans from the suspension. Climate control. Heated seats, another thing which I'm not a huge fan of. It has got the eco button, so when you come to traffic lights or whatever and put your foot on the brake, the car stops. It's me having been in the motor trade for 40 years plus, that's a very, very unnatural thing to happen. When you pull up at traffic lights and your car stops, it used to mean that there was something wrong with the tick over screw, the idle screw. Now it's a feature. Just been serviced, car's done, I can remember 84,000 miles. It just feels like it's done 48,000 miles. Headlamp wash, xenons. Really, really stylish car. that steering is beautiful. It makes you want to drive faster than you should do. Quite a tight 90 degree left here, and a lot of times it's very, very slippy. Car just goes round. Always been a big fan of Mercedes-Benz. Control, that's the little lever on the left hand side here, just underneath the indicator stalk. There's also a speed limiter, but if you just knock the arm up, put your cruise control on. Multifunction steering wheel, volume controls on the right hand side, and telephone controls, automatic headlights. So good on this car. CD radio, and in the I think it's the front central armrest, you have an auxiliary input. The car's got a full service history, and it's just been MOT'd. Diamond cut. I think just about everybody's commented how good looking this car is. It's finished in platinum silver. Actually, it's not platinum silver, it's palladium silver. Mercedes-Benz leather with Alcantara centre panels. The red stitching really finishes it off. You've got three choices from the switch here. At the moment it's just in drive. Click it once, goes into sport, holds it in gear longer. accelerates faster. The next switch is manual, so then you just use it as a manual box but with paddle shift, or with a gear shift. If you move it to the right or left, it's up and down. We don't want that though, so back into automatic. Also has tire pressure monitors. You can also go through your phone book once it's synced. Contacts come up there in the centre. That's a very good road so far, but tags this one to use myself, but I like it that much. As I say, the steering is just, even on a bad road like this, very, very precise and nice. We've got two remote control keys for it. part of, well, we're just on the outskirts of Preston now, just come past Tuck Holes there. Change is imperceptible really with the paddle shift. Just dropped a couple of gears there. Road, there's a reservoir at the left there. Probably won't be able to see from the position of the camera, but now going to head towards Rivington, which is one of my favourite roads. Especially on a motorbike. Exactly the Stelvio Pass, but not too far from Preston, so good enough for me. sheep on the road, and hopefully nothing coming around this bend, which we need to warn them. A lot of motorbikes come up here, and it's a long way down on that side. Not to mention the damage the sheep would get. The Parktronic on the car, which is fitted front and back as well. We've got plenty of kids. I'm losing a few. nowhere in the C-class to fasten the camera, so at the moment it's fastened to the window, so you kind of not getting a centralised view. I may see if I can rig the camera up so that you can get a view from the middle when I get a little bit more time. But it's the car's a joy to drive. Sport seats as well, they really support you, stop you rolling around the corners. And it's, let's see, of a turn of the steering wheel equates to kind of a 90 degree fairly sharp turn. Cut right of the way there, but state of the roads here, I was going to say it makes you wonder why you pay your road tax, but this particular car is, I think it's only £130 for a year. Being the BLUEEFFICIENCY model. So perhaps that's why they can't afford to repair the roads around here. Eco button, just cut the engine out. That was a place called Chorley. There, but no reason. Gearbox, we're doing 70 miles an hour, about 2,300 revs. It's an 84,578 miles. At the moment, the instantaneous fuel consumption is showing, well, we just started to go uphill, but we're showing 40 miles per gallon. It has an eco display, gives you acceleration, constant and coasting. grief, what a shit driver.